Welcome to a new Team CGC 9.8 video. So today I want to talk about some Underfollowed X-Men CGC 9.8 comics that I think you want to consider now before some of these MCU X-Men movies come out, hopefully within the next 5 years. And certainly, like, some of the bigger key issues are awesome too, and they've done really well in value, like Avengers Annual 10, Uncanny X-Men 266 and 244, yeah, First Gambit and Jubilee. But today we'll focus on some more Underfollowed ones. All right, first up, I got a pretty cool one, Uncanny X-Men, number 166. This one's the first appearance of Lockheed, a really cool kind of Colossus cover with the, this is a giant size book too. Usually they're pretty tough to find in the 9.8 giant size books. But first, Lockheed, who's basically like an alien dragon that is the companion of Kitty Pride, pretty much. So it's like, you know, first appearance of a dragon. Yeah, that could be cool if that, you know, they make Lockheed in the MCU. So this one is kind of cool from a couple angles, I think, and decently affordable. 263, 9.8. So I think great cover. So I think a lot of people have kind of just wanted this one. And certainly there's probably some dragon fans or something like that. 263, 9.8, 42.8%, the 9.8 ratio. So of all graded copies, 42.8% of them are 9.8. It's not too bad. You maybe like to see that a bit lower. But so this one, most of the prices I'm seeing lately, 200 to 225. And I think last year and even before that, this one was kind of 150 to 175. So, you know, all X-Men books are kind of doing pretty good. So I think 200 to 225, if you want this one, is a pretty good buy. And, you know, maybe you're kind of nostalgic for this cover or something. And, you know, I don't really remember this one from, when I was a kid. But it being a giant size and that first appearance with a great cover, it's pretty wantable. Okay, next one here. So on some Underfollowed X-Men CGC 9.8s. Astonishing X-Men number 6. This one's cool. It's the first mention of S.W.O.R.D. Really cool cover, too. This is one I've remembered, even sort of being out of the hobby at this time. I just really remember this one from getting back into things as a really cool cover. A cool modern X-Men cover. First mention of S.W.O.R.D., which I'm pretty sure they've introduced that them in a, well, they've done it in a lot of MCU things, but a lot so in the Wanda Vision series. And it's first full appearance of Abigail Brand, who knows, maybe they bring her into the MCU as well. There's 209.8. Not too bad. This one's a modern one. Pretty underfollowed, though. 71.4% of all graded copies are CGC 9.8. So not any particular rarity in the high grade, unfortunately. But more will be graded, and maybe that'll come down. So saw one sell in an auction, too. So I think this one's being somewhat speculated on as well. $239.99. Whereas, again, similar to that Lockheed book, I'm pretty sure a year and a half ago, prices were about $175, maybe even $150 if you were really patient in an auction. And maybe even now in an auction. That was an auction, $239.39. But maybe if you get lucky, closer to $200. But given that first mention of S.W.O.R.D., cool cover, first Abigail Brand, this is another one that's kind of underfollowed, but you can imagine some upside to it, I would think. All right, next one's a cool one, yeah. So I got a couple raw copies here of Uncanny X-Men 158. So this is the first Rogue in title in the Uncanny X-Men. And these are actually pretty nice copies. I picked them up for $5, I remembered, as when I was getting back into the hobby, just as a kind of under the radar key, 158, and they were the right price. So this one is kind of a cool secondary Rogue key, because certainly Avengers Annual 10 is kind of the one to get. But 284, 9.8s in the blue label and the 9.8 for this one. 30%, the CGC 9.8 percentage. So a book of this age, that's decent, but not anything to sort of, you know, get excited about. And saw a few sell here for a $199.99. I'm pretty sure that was today, too, just in the last few hours here, and another one for $229.99. So that's kind of the range on this one. And as a secondary Rogue key, because in the 9.8 Avengers Annual 10 is like $1,400 now, so I think this one's making sense. If you're the biggest Rogue fan, it's probably one you want. Cool cover too, Dave Cockrum cover, like classic X-Men style. Actually a pretty cool cover. Okay, next Underfollowed X-Men one is the one that I am kind of looking out for, I think. An X-Men Adventures number 1. in the 9.8s, a pretty cool one, I think. And this is basically an adaptation of the X-Men animated series from the early 90s. And I love that show as a kid. You kind of get in this one, because he wasn't a part of X-Men comics, a first appearance of Morph. And every now and then I'll see like a Morph super rumor, but probably not going to happen, that, you know, maybe they'll bring Morph back in some MCU X-Men movies. So I think this one's just a cool one. Saw some prices selling in the last few weeks, and I was kind of hitting myself maybe for not searching for this one, because it would have been really hard not to pull the trigger. But there's only 31 CGC 9.8s of X-Men Adventures, which is such a great collector item. Yeah, I think that's 31. 33% of all graded copies are 9.8s too. So that's kind of trending pretty rare in the 9.8 for a book that's not heavily graded at all, only 31 9.8s. So there was a seller that had two of these, and, you know, probably got them graded themselves. The seller had two of them in stock. They both sold for $159 in the CGC 9.8. I think that's a target to aim for with this one. You got maybe the upside of Morph, plus just a cool one that is under collected, I think, for how many people love the X-Men animated series. Why not just get, you know, the adaptation in comic book form in the perfect grade for $150, like, or what was it, $159? That's a great deal, I think. So, yeah, an Underfollowed X-Men one you want to consider. Okay, next one. Marvel Collectible Classics X-Men number one. This one's cool. That definitely flies under the radar and talked about on a few videos here. And a great collector item in the 9.8. It reprints X-Men number one and two, the Silver Age book, which is so cool. So just from that standpoint, it's collectible. There's 69 CGC 9.8s in the blue label. So 1 is 69 is looking really cool too. 73.4% of all graded copies are CGC 9.8. This one's kind of a chromium type of cover from that era, which are a little bit tougher, I think. So they kind of resist maybe a little bit of spine wear. So not really particularly rare in the 9.8. 73.4% of all graded copies are 9.8s. Lower the better with the 9.8 ratios. So this one, I mentioned on a past video, one sold for $149.99. That's a great deal, I think, being that there's only 69 of these out there. Not a lot of these sell, so you're not seeing like too much sales data. But given how X-Men seems to have come along here in the last month or two, for sure, with rumors heating up and whatever it might be, books, you know, big keys taken off in value, I think if you could get this one for $150, it's a screaming buy. But you maybe even pay up to like $200, $225-ish in the 9.8 for this one. That reprint of X-Men 1 and 2. This one's just a cool one from a lot of angles. Okay, next, Underfollowed one. A bit older here. A cool one, though. Uncanny X-Men, number 117. First appearance of the Shadow King, who's a pretty cool villain. And you don't hear about, you know, Shadow King too much, but he could definitely transfer on to like you know, the big screen in the MCU pretty easily, I think. And this is a cool collector item. It's from the John Byrne, you know, Terry Austin era of X-Men, which is really classic. 157 CGC 9.8s in the blue label, and 12.4% of all graded copies are CGC 9.8s. Now this is a 1979 book, and that's great still. Of all graded copies, only 12.4% of them are the high grade 9.8. That's awesome. 1979 book, getting older, so you expect them to be a little bit lower during this time. Quite a few of these graded, yeah. This is one I've sort of wanted to target in the past as just an Underfollowed X-Men villain that you can get pretty cheaper in the 9.8, yet a really great collector item. And I almost purchased one. I remember it was like $230 to $250-ish area. And that would have been, you know, a year and a half to 2 years ago at this point. Seeing some sell though for $400. Yep, someone sell for $400. And Go Collect has it at $300. And a lot of times, if you're not paying for Go Collect, which I don't, they're not going to give you like super updated prices. But one selling for $400 on eBay. A cool one though. First Shadow King from the era, one of 157, is a pretty cool collector item. Okay, a next one a little bit more affordable, and maybe you're more speculating on some MCU happenings, but a cool book. It's Uncanny X-Men 211 in the CGC 9.8. First full appearance of Marauders. I think this begins the first part one of Mutant Massacre, maybe, storyline. It's this sort of you know, run of X-Men books for, you know, four or five issues there is a pretty cool story and well collected. And being the first full appearance of Marauders, Mr. Sinister's goons are pretty much the Marauders, so there's been a lot of rumors about Mr. Sinister is probably possibly going to be, we'll say, just rumors, that he might be the villain in the next MCU movie. Well, if that happens, he'll probably have some like henchmen doing his dirty work, and the Marauders will probably be in the movie. So I think it's a pretty decent spec right now, and a cool book, yeah, no doubt, from that well-collected story. 643 CGC 9.8s in the blue label, 40.8%, the 9.8%. So there's quite a few of them out there. A popular era of X-Men, and not really particularly rare, but it keeps it somewhat affordable. This is one I really kind of recommended as an underfollowed one that you could get for like 120 or 110. That's what I was saying on the video that we did about a month or two ago. Looking at some completed sales, though, C1 sell for $179.50, and there was an auction. It was in a new case with even like a new label on the CGC, so it was looking pretty good, but still a direct edition, sold for $213.50. So that, you know, yeah, I think maybe some people agreeing with me there that if Mr. Sinister does get in the MCU movies, you might see the Marauders. So I thought it was undervalued around 100, but, you know, maybe a little over 200 might not be worth it. But, you know, in the new case, it was looking pretty cool. But, yeah, one to look out for, I think. Or, yeah, Uncanny X-Men 211, maybe in the Raw, or all of these in the Raw, certainly. Look out for them. Pretty great underfollowed X-Men ones to consider. All right, last one on the list here. It's a Wolverine 88. Yeah, and I brought a couple of them out here in the CGC 9.8. It's a pretty cool one. One that's a personal favorite of mine from the 90s. It's the first time Wolverine and Deadpool fight. But it's really become well collected. It's almost, I almost think of it as like the 90s version of Hulk 340. So Hulk 340 is the second time Wolverine and Hulk ever fight. The first time is in Wolverine's first appearance. But this one's the first, kind of happens in the 90s, first appearance of Wolverine versus, or first time Wolverine and Deadpool fight. Super cool book, great cover, I thought, too. One I remember from collecting comics in the 90s. I got three of them in the 9.8. There's 113 9.8s out there. This one's a bit weird on the census. They started separating the deluxe edition from the normal edition. I believe they started doing that like 2 to 3 years ago. So if you notice here, these are the exact same book, but on the CGC label, there's no deluxe edition here. Whereas on this one, it's a new, more newly graded one. You see a deluxe edition on the CGC label. Same book, though. So the census is a bit weird how they've done that. There's 113 9.8, some of them being the more rare non-deluxe edition, which has a different price. I'm pretty sure a different type of paper as well, but looks the same. It doesn't say deluxe on the cover, too, which is only printed here on like the small red. So it looks exactly the same almost. So, in the 9.8, you know, people, like, Deadpool 3 is coming out. Maybe they introduce, like, X-Men in the MCU with, like, Wolverine in the Deadpool 3 movie or something. Like, people are just speculating on the best possible thing right now with Wolverine. Because, you know, it is possible. Deadpool coming back to the MCU, X-Men coming out in the MCU in the next 5 years. So, this one makes sense. And in the 9.8, $457.87 I saw one sell for. So that's pretty expensive. You know, I bought one of mine like 2.5 years ago for like $58 in an auction that was in Canada, and I was just on top of my searches and it popped up and I bid like $100 or something and I got it for $58. Another one I bought for $100, and the other one I bought about 6 months ago for $145, I think it was. So this one's kind of really come a long way, I think, since Deadpool 3 is coming out, and just people are looking for kind of really cool secondary Deadpool keys to maybe speculate on. But this one, yeah, it's just a cool one. And only a 1 of 113. Yeah, getting into the, I think it's a 94 book, is it? Yeah, 94. So still probably somewhat heavily printed, but there doesn't seem to be too many in the 9.8. So a great collector item, and yeah, an underfollowed X-Men book you want to consider. Yeah, and I've talked about that one since like the beginning of the channel almost. That was one of my initial underfollowed ones when I got back into the hobby that I targeted as just being super cool. And, you know, first Wolverine and versus Deadpool just sounded awesome to me, and remembered the cover. So, okay, that was all 8 there, I think it was. Yeah, so I'll have them in a list in the description below if you want to have a look. So, top picks. Okay, so first top pick, Wolverine 88 for sure. Because, you know, I ended up buying 3 of them, kind of put my money where my mouth is. That's always the biggest measure of if you, you know, have a top pick or if you want the book or not. So Wolverine 88 has got to be my top pick. The second pick here, I really like Astonishing X-Men number 6. Yeah, I think, you know, they're using S.W.O.R.D. in some of these MCU shows and things like that. They've slowly introduced that, and a great cover, collectible cover as well, and maybe they come in with an Abigail Brand in the next MCU. That could be another way this one does well. So that's my second one. Third top pick, actually, pretty much I got a five-way tie because I was like, yeah, that's my top pick. And I'm like, no, wait, that one's probably better. So five-way tie here between X-Men Adventures number 1, first Morph, Marvel Collectible Classics, X-Men number 1, great one, can't. Uncanny X-Men 158, first Rogue and Uncanny, that's just a cool Underfollowed one. I think you get it for a great price, that's a cool one. Uncanny X-Men 117. Yeah, great Underfollowed villain. First Shadow King, one of 157 collector item. And tied, I'll do Uncanny X-Men 211. So first full appearance of Marauders, I think is a decent speculation right now, and just a cool book too, that even if Mr. Sinister or the Marauders don't get in the MCU, it's just kind of a cool one. Okay, so five-way tie for the third pick. So I guess Uncanny X-Men 166, first Lockheed, was kind of the outsider, because, you know, I don't foresee them maybe putting a dragon in the next MCU X-Men movies, but maybe not. That could be super cool. Yeah, there's they went with Guardians of the Galaxies with the live raccoon, so who knows? Okay, so I've just, you know, noticed that some of the X-Men keys have just done so well, and for good reason, like, you know, first Rogue, first Gambit, first Jubilee. You know, hopefully they're in the movie and they do really well continually. But a few more under the radar ones to consider, I think, still have some more upside. And yeah, certainly kind of pounding the table on Wolverine 88, I guess, even though, because I've been talking about it for quite a while, it seems. But even though it's done so well in price, like, you know, $457.87, I'd really hope to get this under $400 still, hopefully in a lull. But Deadpool 3 is coming out, so it's a tough environment to get that one on a deal or anything like that. Okay, we'll leave it at that though. Thanks so much for the support, team. Yeah, hopefully you got some ideas. And I'll see you on the next one.